So actually, I was fiddling around with this and I got at least 500 watts out of it.
Alright, where are we at? That's an RMS meter too. Oh, real close to 500.
500 is right in the middle. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. But your average is kind of right around here, so
I don't have the other meter hooked up, so I don't know what it's actually doing. But it's about the same results as the other amp with the crappy tubes. So, anyway, I don't know, but if it had, I think, all the proper parts, I think it would probably do about 900 on 10 meters. So, anyway, that's the HL2200, and they have the matching SA2060A tuner. They're pretty matching. They're both brown. They're both from the Xena era. If you look at the logo here, that's Zenith. That's totally Zenith. It's even got like the Z in between the 2 kilowatt. Which, that's 2 kilowatts input power, by the way. Which basically cut that in half, 1200. These things don't really, you know, do 1200 most of the time anyway. It depends on the bands. It's usually on the CW part of the band. And, anyway, I've had it for a while, and I use it every once in a while just to kind of dust it off, but it had problems, so I had to completely take it apart, and I found that cold solder joint in the tank circuit. I think somebody had traded this, like, several different times, and it got passed on from person to person, and nobody could get it to work, and they couldn't figure out why it didn't work, and the very, very bottom of the tank coil had a cold solder joint that looked like it was normal. And I got so frustrated with it, I started to take it completely apart. And I pulled the whole RF deck out to paint that back area that you guys saw. And that's when I found it. And so it was like, wow, cool. So, yeah,